We will start our problem with a half circle with the diameter of 18. Then we will use the right radius of this half circle to form another half circle inside it. And we will inscribe a full circle in the remaining area, as you can see on the sketch. The question is, can we somehow calculate the area of this red inscribed circle? This problem was presented to me by one of my subscribers from Venezuela, Maria. So thank you, Maria, for this wonderful suggestion. So if you want to, you can pause this video right now, try it yourself, and then come back and check the solution. Alright, so let's solve this one together. So we're going to start by labeling the center of our big half circle as O. Then we will also label the center of our inscribed full circle as A. Now let's have a look only at our big half circle and our inscribed circle. Let's first notice the radius of our big half circle. Since the diameter is equal to 18, this means that the radius must be equal to 9. And let's also label the radius of our inscribed circle as R. And finally, we will label the intersection point between those two circles as P. Now, let's rotate our small radius to the point P. And let's also do the same for the radius of our half circle. You can see that both of those radii will be located at the same line. We actually know this for the fact by using the theorem of a circle, which states that if two circles touch each other externally or internally, in this case, then their point of contact lies on a straight line joining their centers. So this is exactly our case here. Now, with this in mind, we can easily calculate the segment AO from this sketch. We know that the line OP is equal to the line OA plus the line AP. So, this means that we can calculate AO as the difference between two radii of our circles, and this will be 9 minus r. Now we can rotate the radius of our small circle to the intersection point between this circle and the diameter of our half circle. And we can label this point of contact as C. We know for the fact that this radius will be perpendicular to the diameter of our big half circle. We know this from a tangent of a circle theorem, which states that if we have a tangent to a circle and we pull a radius to the point of tangency, then the radius will be perpendicular to the tangent line. This is exactly our case here, since the diameter of the big half circle is actually the tangent of our inscribed circle. Alright, so now let's have a look at the right angle triangle ACO, and let's label its base as X. Now we can use the Pythagorean theorem on this triangle. We can say that the hypotenuse OA squared is equal to the leg AC squared plus the leg CO squared. Of course, we can substitute our values from the sketch, and we can expand the left side of the equation by using the square of binomial to get the following. Now we can simplify by cancelling r square on both sides of the equation, and we will get the following. From here we will just rearrange our terms a little bit to get that 18r is equal to 81 minus x squared. So now let's go back and take a look at our inscribed half circle on the right. We can label its center as B, and since we know that the diameter of this half circle is equal to 9, then its radius must be equal to 9 over 2. Now let's label the point of contact between our inscribed half circle and full circle as Q. Then we can rotate the radius of our full circle to the point Q, and we can do the same with the radius of our small half circle. As you can see, those two radii will again form the straight line. We of course know this by using the same theorem as we did before, that if two circles touch each other, but this time externally, Then their point of contact will again lie on a straight line which joins their centers. So this is exactly our case. Now let's have a look at the right angle triangle ABC. And we can use the Pythagorean theorem again. We can say that the hypotenuse AB squared is equal to the leg AC squared plus the leg CB squared, and we can substitute our values from the sketch. Now we can expand both sides of the equation by using the square of binomial and get something like this. We can of course simplify this by first cancelling r squared on the both sides and then cancel 81 over 4 as well. Then we are going to be left with 9r, which equals to x squared plus 9x. And we're going to use this with our previous equation to form a system of equations. Now we're just going to solve this system. But first we're going to expand our second equation with 2. In this way, we will get that both of those equations will be equal to 18r. So this means that now we can combine them. We can say that 81 minus x squared must be equal to 2x squared plus 18x. Now we can just put all our terms on the same side of the equation, and then we can simplify with 3 to get this really nice quadratic equation of x squared plus 6x minus 27, which equals to 0. Now we can solve this equation in multiple ways, but I will use the quadratic formula, which states that if we have a quadratic equation in the form of ax squared plus bx plus c that is equal to 0, then you can solve the values of x by using this quadratic formula. Of course, we're just going to substitute the values of a, b, and c from our equation, and we will get the following. Now, I am going to do this step by step, since many of you asked me in the comments to show all the steps individually. So, if you simplify this, you will get the following. Then we can just simplify the things underneath the square root, and we will get the square root of 144, which means that we will get minus 6 plus minus 12 over 2. Now we can simplify, and we will get that our two values of x will be equal minus 3 plus minus 6, which means that our first value of x will be minus 9, and our second value will be equal to 3. Of course, we know that the length of the line cannot be a negative value, so minus 9 is out of the question, and this means that x must be equal to 3. Now we can just substitute this value of x into any of those two equations from the beginning, and for this video I will choose to substitute this into our first equation without any particular reason. So if we do this, we will get the following. We can simplify this and finally get that 18r is equal to 72, which means that the radius of our inscribed circle is equal to 4. Now it's pretty easy for us to find the area of this circle. Since the area is equal to pi r squared, we're just going to substitute the value of r and finally get that the area of our inscribed red circle is equal to 16 pi squared units, and this is our solution. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and if you did, do not hesitate to leave a like or subscribe to the channel, it really means a lot. Of course, if you found another way to solve this problem, please feel free to write it down in the comment section below. I always love to see how community finds totally different solutions for the same problem. And until next time, as always, see you all and take care.